Hello, I'm Martinez. I'm making this action co-op game where the player has to assemble the conveyor line and ship the goods out of the factory. In short, player grabs and drags missing conveyor parts, installs them in the correct place, hoping that he did a good job, starts the conveyor and ships the goods out of the factory. Well, let's begin devlog number 3. In this video, I'll show you what challenges and difficulties I had creating the shredder mechanic. Actually, when I was making the shredder, I had one main question which haunted me. Will the player be able to fall into a shredder? Of course, this question will be answered in this video. And don't you even dare to skip it through. No, actually, I'm kidding. It's your time. I respect it. Do whatever you need to. So I thought, it would be fun to make conveyors break down after some time using. Of course, player has time to fix it, but what if he doesn't fix it on time?
He has to be punished.
Okay, maybe it sounds a bit harsh, but in the game design terms, the game has to give negative feedback for wrong actions or decisions. So the conveyor breaks down and stops completely. Player has to drag broken part into a shredder, shred it to pieces in order to get a new one. And then install the new part and start the conveyor again. Well, it takes time for a player to do all that. But what he was doing with all that time not fixing the conveyor, right? So I believe you understood what I'm trying to do, and I got a green light to show you how I've done it. So, as all the game models are very basic and simple, in order to keep the uniform style, there are no exceptions with the shredder model. I made something like a container with an open top. Added two rotors, or I'm not even sure how to call them, they will be spinning inwards and pulling stuff inside. Okay, so you are thinking, how the player is gonna draw things in when it's so high? Yeah, I was thinking that too. And I have a solution, which is a conveyor. So unexpected, huh? I believe it is, since the game is like a one big conveyor. Okay, now that I've modeled the shredder, I need a machine that spawns new recycled parts. So I've made this. But I think something has to push the conveyors out. And you've guessed it, it's another conveyor. I uploaded the model to Unity, created the materials, and started coding its mechanics. Let's use the same conveyor track script I've made in a previous devlog. How to activate it? Oh, a button. Done. And now, the question you've been waiting for. What happens if a player falls in? Wait, this is even funnier. I'll show you the bugged version of it. So, who ordered a burger? Coming right up? Oh, sorry to interrupt the video, however, it would be a great help if you'd visit this game's Steam page and add it to your wishlist. Link is in the description. So I ran into a problem. Since I'm using the same conveyor model, it's very hard to tell which one can break down. To fix that, I made a new conveyor model. It does look a bit broken, like a recycled one. I added the model to Unity and made the shaking animation. It's for more visual feedback. So how I've done the animation system? Actually, it's pretty simple. The base layer uses standard animation states like move to construction, place, or back to idle. And for the shaking, I've added extra layer with additive blending. And in that layer, I created a blend tree. So the blend tree is a simple solution to blend different animations into one by a given parameter. In this particular case, I'm blending two animations which are breaking and idle. Okay, you may think this is a bit complicated and why I don't use just a simple animation instead. I did this because the shaking of a conveyor is based on the breaking timer, meaning that the more time it passed, the stronger conveyor shakes. I think it looks kind of okay, but it's still missing something, particle effects. And now it's much better. Well, the only thing left is to make that the shredder destroy broken parts and spawn new ones instead. And I believe that's it. The shredder mechanic is done. And as always, thank you for your time. I really hope you like this devlog series and we will meet again in the next video. Bye.